In this tutorial, I will be showing how to export a model for Amnesia, The Dark Descent. Note, this information applies to Blender version 2.6 and probably later. We will make do with the default cube. Note, even though the default cube is used, the same information will still apply for more sophisticated shapes. However, when dealing with armatures, HPL2 requires the machine for pig's patch, but we will not touch on that here. Exporting non-animated models for Amnesia from Blender, however, is quite simple. All you have to do is make the mesh ready for export before exporting the model. To do this, we must first make sure of a few things. First, we must make sure a material is applied to all meshes. In Blender, to apply a material, make sure the mesh is selected. Then click on the Material tab to the right. From the drop-down menu, select the material you want for the mesh. For our default cube, the default material will work fine for our purposes. Next, we need to apply a texture to the material. To do this, click on the Textures tab to the right. From the Textures drop-down menu, select the texture you want for the mesh. For our default cube, the default texture will be fine. Next, change the texture type to Image or Movie. Then, for the image, click on New. This will bring up a menu for generated image types. For this tutorial, we'll create a color grid, sized by 256 by 256 pixels. In practice, you would want the image source to be from a single image. Next, we need to change the mapping coordinates to UV. Now is the time where we unwrap our mesh, which specifies the UV coordinates of the mesh. For convenience, create a new viewport on the side, and pick UV Image Editor from the Editor menu. With the mesh selected, hit Tab to enter Edit Mode. For our default cube, we do not need to do any sophisticated forms of unwrap. But first, make sure our color grid texture is the active texture for our mesh. Then, for convenience, we'll reset the unwrap by hitting U for unwrap on the keyboard and choosing Reset. Now, when we change our shading to texture mode, we will see the texture applied to the mesh. For the sake of providing troubleshooting information, we will head straight to exporting the mesh to Collada format. Cameras and lights cannot be imported into the HPL2 engine, so we will delete them before exporting. Now, go to File, Export, Collada. At the bottom left corner of the screen, you will observe options for Collada export. What you would want to have selected at this point are: include UV textures, and copy, under texture options. We will deselect triangulate so that we may observe a specific phenomenon. After exporting, load the DAI file into the HPL2 model viewer. We do not care how it looks in the model viewer, we are merely using the model viewer's HPL2 material generating feature. That is, when you open a model in the model viewer, it will automatically create an HPL2 material file for the mesh's diffuse texture. Now, close the model viewer and open the HPL2 model editor. Import the DAI file into the model editor from the File menu. After doing so, you will observe the aforementioned phenomenon. That is, the mesh appears to be incomplete and full of holes. To fix this, we must export the model in triangulated form. So, close the model editor and go back into Blender and re-export the mesh, this time with the triangulate option checked. Re-importing the model into the HPL2 model editor, then, we'll have expected results. Now, let's say you want to have several objects with different scales, rotated differently and positioned wherever you please. After having adjusted your meshes accordingly, when importing the objects into HPL2, do you observe the meshes to not acknowledge those properties? That is, are they not scaled, positioned and rotated like they are in Blender? If so, this is easily resolved by applying these properties before exporting. Do this for all objects that you have modified these properties. However, avoid doing it for armatures. It should also be noted that you should avoid enabling the option to apply modifiers at export. Having Blender apply modifiers automatically when exporting may have undesirable results. Those are the fundamental things you need to know for exporting your models from Blender for the HPL2 engine.